Hello everyone, Suman Pachigola here, and today in this video we are going to understand what is web server, application server, database servers, how exactly it works and how you can understand in very easy manner. Alright, and if you are from a non-techie background, this video is going to be useful for you. Alright, so now let's go in. So how exactly web server, application server, database servers are connected, I'm going to show you in a very simple example. What is that? So let's take this as an example of hotel, right? This is a hotel and you went to a hotel and you ordered for something else. So let me demonstrate all this in a very simple terms. So there will be a client, then there's a web server, application server, database servers. Okay, now you got to understand through this example. I'll see if I could explain you more easy manner. Here you are the customer. Now you went to hotel. What you will do? You will be connecting with a server, right? Whoever serves you food. So now in this case you are a client and you called a server. Now what did you do? You asked a server for a bottle of water or glass of water, and this server went here somewhere and this person brought you a glass of water or a water bottle. Now did you go there only for water bottle or to drink water? Up to you. Now after you drinking, you may go away. Or if you want another more food, what did you do? You will give more orders. Now this waiter or this server doesn't have anything here because this person has to go to the kitchen and get it done according to your menu orders and bring it back to you. So now this person, now what did you do? You have ordered for some sort of food that you wanted to have. Now what this person has done, this waitress went inside and told the chef that, hey, this number table that client wants so and so food, now prepare it. And what this person has done, this person went inside the fridge or maybe wherever there is a storage of ingredients and prepared that food and get it served to you. Got it? Now this is exactly what happens in the internet or somewhere here and there. Now if the internet is or the application that you are trying to reach or get the information, first you need to understand that if that is a hotel, they need to ensure that the server, the waitress or the waiter, whoever is directly connecting with the person or the client, should understand the language, correct? Because the chef understands your language or not, that's a different story, but the waitress or waiter needs to understand your language so that it can be communicated properly here to the chef, and finally it will be delivered to you in a proper manner the way you wanted. The same thing happens on the web. So here, if you see, here is the client, that you are someone who are accessing an application or information on the web through computer, mobile, iPad or anything that per se, online, right, with a connection of internet. What it happens, so it goes through the internet and it touches the web server. Okay, web server, what web server is? A computer. It's a computer system which enables the web to host web pages. Okay, I'm gonna show you what is that and we'll go deep. And now if something is not available here, it sends a request here and it gets it done through databases, meaning you see it's a transformed data with business logic. So there is a logic written in here and here servlets run here. So servlets is a small Java program that enables, that connects the web servers and that helps the application server, web servers to share the data or pages through online, through internet. Got it? So that's how it works. So now what happened when you access here as a client? It goes through the HTTP protocol. So now web server, there are various types of web servers that we are going to understand, but here you got to understand a few things, that web server is a computer application. Sorry, it's a computer system like the normal computer that you use, but it has a software installed, web server software installed, and that enables the web pages to run. So if we see in web servers, there are multiple types of web servers, so we're going to discuss that. But here you need to understand that whatever the information is not available or the data is not available according to the software, according to the application or the website that you're accessing, what it will do is it will send a request to the application server that, hey, this client wants this more information, can you get it? Now it goes to the database and gets information and it passes it to you so that you can translate the same thing once again and this client can see it. All right, so what are the examples here? The web server is, it's a system where the websites are hosted. So websites are consist of one page or it could be the multiple pages. All right. So now let's understand the example. For example, here, if you go to sumanpachigula.com, you will see it has been hosted on HTTP server. Now, this is not a dynamic page, meaning dynamic is that all the time a data will be renewed or updated. It is called a static page. So anytime you go through this URL, you will see this page. So let me show you something live. Okay, yes, this is a live page. If you see, yes, now this is what in a browser. In a browser, if you hit sumanpachigula.com, you mention this URL, you will go to a HTTP server. See how I'm fumbling. Now, is it consist of only one page? No, it is consist of multiple pages. It will go to the mentorship page. It is another page which is also hosted in there and get the information for you. Now there is more. Why is Suman? It's another page. It is, once you click it, it will take you to the another page. Okay, you want to understand what is book, then you click on the tab and it will go and gets the information that is stored in web server and it is showing you. Now this information is static, you cannot communicate, meaning whatever the page brings, now you could able to read it. So in these cases where there are websites which are not dynamic, which are has only static information, that uses a different host. And if those are like a bigger application, bigger websites, those uses different sort of hosts. At the same time, they use application servers because there is nothing that you get more information, right? This is just a simple website. Now if we talk about more complicated, so this is the example I wanted to show you. This is IRCTC, right? To book a train. Now this website built on HTTP server, and this website is built with HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or could be jQuery. All right. Now, this information, whatever you are seeing, this is the information, this interactive web page. Now, whatever the information that web server can fetch, it can do it. For example, now, if you want this page, buses, right? This page might be in web server, and retiring room you clicked. So it went to the tourism website. You see, it went to the tourism website and it fetched you the tourism pages. Now, but if you want to book a ticket, for example, if I want to book to New Delhi to Hyderabad, okay, and I'm gonna put the date somewhere 30th, and I'll search, right? Now it went inside the database and it gave me a real-time information. So this is not, if someone is booking, if somewhere in 2 minutes, if it has been 10 tickets booked, so it will become 90. So how will it happen? It happens when the web server interacts with application server, then application server went to the database, it goes to the database and it checks, okay, how many real-time tickets are available. Now it helps us book it. Got it? And that is how it works. Now you understood about this page, right? How static it is. And so now let's understand the examples. So here, what did you do? You enter to sumanpachigola.com, and it went through a request, HTTP request, and it found that request and it gave you a page. So far so good. Now you entered irctc.co.in and it went to the web server. It has shown you the page. So far so good. Now you wanted to book a ticket, so you entered New Delhi to Hyderabad. Now web server took this, and that information, if that is available in web server, it's okay. If not, it will send a request to application server that, hey, we need real-time data. Now, can you show that? Now, it goes inside the database, fetches all the information that, okay, what is the trains are there? What is the current running status? How many berths are there? Which class? Everything information, it gets it from the database or wherever it is. And it sends you back to the web server and it sends back to the client. Got it? And that is how it works. So, as you understood, web server is a system, it's a computer system where the websites are hosted. So it could be like it's a computer system where it's a website or hosted, the way mine is in GoDaddy, right? That's been hosted in Suman Pachigola, has been hosted there. Now that is the HTTP is Apache web server, and Apache who is providing this service, and this has been used by it's been used worldwide. Do you think it is the only one? No, there are other web servers as well. So there are the differences in systems, computer systems we spoke, right? Okay, a computer system could be a web server. So now you need to understand that to enable what is differentiates a computer system and a web server. So here, computer system, if you need to work, you may not need internet, right? Anything, you can do few things, whatever you wanted to do on computer system. But for a web server, it needs a internet through which it can corresponds live, you know, with the client whoever requests information. Now there are two types of web servers, I told, right? I have shown you two types of website. One is a static website, sumanpachigola.com, where whatever the information is there, you will read, you consume, and you take the next step. Another one is irctc.co.in. Now what is that happens, that is not for information, but that you wanted to engage with it too. You need some information, you need to book your ticket. In that cases, that is what is different in these two, static and dynamic. Now when the website which is static, meaning which has only information based, those are hosted in shared hosts. So web server has two different, one is shared host, another is dedicated host. So in shared hosts, what happened, there are so many websites will be hosted there, like mine, okay, which are more of information based or very little bit of whatever you can do with that. And now in dedicated host, what happened, that is primarily with dedicated. So for irctc.co.in, for Indian Railway, they have a different server that is been monitored by people. So they do not allow anybody else's websites will be hosted there, should be hosted there. Got it? Because it has a very big. So here another example could be where there is less traffic, right? If there are manageable amount of people are visiting a website, that can be hosted in shared host. If there are so many thousands and lakhs of people are accessing, and but for more of a dynamic or interactive way, it needed a dedicated host. Okay, so you got to remember that. Now let's go and understand the examples. So here, client, who is a client? That whoever accesses the pages through mobile, laptop, desktop, iPad, whatever the source. Now examples of web servers. Web server is a what? It's a computer system where web server software is been hosted, installed, and these websites are hosted there. So these web servers are Apache HTTPS server, this is Microsoft's IIS and LegitPD, Sun Java System web server, Jigsaw server. These are few examples of web servers. What is application server? You told, right? Application server is a software system. So it is also a system where it enables an application program to run. It's a software application program to run on it. Now it consists, this server consists of software and hardware. All right. Now these application servers allows facilitates what? Processing power and memory power. So if there is no application server, you cannot book tickets. Like sometimes you hear, right? The server went down, server crashed. This is what happens where there might be so much load came in and it could not able to balance it. Now, this allows the application to run properly on it and gives information whatever asked by the client. So generally we see the IBM, NGX, Tomcat, WebLogic, Web Server, vCenter, all right, JBoss. These are the application servers. Now let's understand database server. So if you see here, what is database? So generally if someone asks you for database, you should be telling that database is it stores data in rows and columns. That's it. So what another functions of database is, it stores information, it retrieves information, it gives an access to manage, it backs up, and what else, and it gives the edit, and it shares the user management and whatnot. It allows you to manipulate data within. So these are the function of the database servers. So Oracle, DB2, Informix, SQL Server, MySQL database, and where you see there is a MongoDB, NoSQL. So I'm going to give you more information in coming videos. So this is how exactly it works: web server, application server, and database server, right? You understood clearly? Meaning, here, you client connected to the web server, whatever the information you wanted, web server has given to you, whatever, if you are asking more complex information and you want to engage more, you want more from the website, what this web server does is it goes to the application server and it tells it this is what my client wants. And what application server does is it goes to the database and gets all the information whatever been asked by the application server, a web server, and it all coordinates and serves it clearly according to the query. Got it? So this is what the clear example of application server, web server, database server, and client. All right. So I hope it helped, and I'll be sharing more this information, and let me know how did this video help you to understand web server, application server, and a database server. Okay. If you're a new visitor, subscribe to this channel, and thank you very much for being here. Take care and bye-bye.